LED lights are everywhere, but how exactly do they work? Hey, it's Dan Zimmerman. Welcome back to the channel, where we'll dive into the best simple explanation of LEDs. Stay tuned to see one of the most advanced LED products in action from Lumary, the leading company in indoor and outdoor LED lights, with a demonstration of their Smart Outdoor Spotlight Pro product. You've seen LEDs on just about everything from lights, TVs, and just about every gadget out there. But what does LED stand for? It stands for Light Emitting Diode. A diode is like a one-way valve for electricity. It allows electric current to flow in one direction, but blocks it from flowing the other way. It's a tiny electronic component that helps control the flow of electricity in circuits, making it a key part of many electronic devices. So a light emitting diode, or LED, is a diode that, as the name suggests, emits light. Remember that in a circuit, electricity or electrons flow from the negative side of the battery and back to the positive. Also keep in mind that the diode symbol's arrows point against the direction of electron flow. Take a look at the symbol for an LED. It's the same as a diode, but with two arrows pointing away. Now that we know what LEDs are, let's take a dive into how they work. When you apply a voltage to a circuit with an LED, it produces light. It all comes from a tiny piece of semiconductor material inside, which is emitting energy as photons. A photon is a tiny particle made up of electromagnetic waves. They have no mass and no charge, and you can think of them as tiny packets of light energy. LEDs emit photons in the visible spectrum to humans, the wavelength of 400 to 700 nanometers. We perceive different colors depending on the length of the wavelength. Here's Lumary's Smart Outdoor Spotlight Pro product that contains RGBAI LED lights. Everything you need is included in the box, including the stakes. And check it out, there's the color LEDs and the white LEDs right there inside the lamp. Setting up the lamps was super easy. It turns out that the stakes that are included are very strong and easily pushed into the ground. I was able to create a really cool outdoor lighting setup along one side of the backyard. It took me less than 30 minutes to do. Lumary's RGBAI technology is unique because it can control the color of every LED light with precision, so that it can not only emit multiple colors at the same time, but as you can see here, it can deliver a really cool rainbow-like effect. I highly recommend this product, and you need to check out the dozens of other products on their site by clicking on links in the description of the video. Be sure to use the promo code ILLUSTRATE2EDUCATE to get 10% off any product. LEDs and diodes work on the same principles, and the fact that they are both made up of semiconductor materials in the middle of an electrical connection. Inside the semiconductor, we have electrons combining with holes and releasing photons in the process. The material that is in the semiconductor layer determines the different color of light that is produced. For example, gallium arsenide phosphide make the color red. So when mixing different materials together to form the semiconductor, this creates different colors of lights like red, green, and blue. We can mix the red, green, and blue to get any color we need, including white light. Inside an LED, there are two metal leads which connect to the main body. The longest is the anode, and the shortest is the cathode. The leads have a metal plate at the end, and they are separated by a small gap. There is a cone shape where there is a semiconductor material made from a layer of N-type with a layer of P-type material. The N-type layer has lots of free electrons, and the P-type is missing some electrons, but it has lots of holes that electrons can sit in. This forms a P-N junction. When the LED is powered, photons are emitted from the P-N junction of the semiconductor, which produces the colored light. The cone helps to reflect the light out. So where do the electrons and holes come from? Silicon on its own has 4 electrons, and when shared with other silicon atoms, has 8 electrons and is considered stable. Then impurities like phosphorus, that has 5 electrons, are added to the N-type layer and are shared with the silicon atoms, making 9 electrons, which allows one electron to move freely. The P-type layer can have some aluminum added, which only has 3 electrons. So there's a hole where the electron can move to. So basically now, there's a layer with too many electrons and a layer with not enough electrons. This p-n junction creates a depletion region that creates a barrier and an electric field. When we connect a battery, the electrons flow through the barrier, creating what is called a forward bias. If there's not enough voltage, then the electrons are not able to break through the barrier. For a small red LED, it may take around 1.7 volts to break through the barrier. There's three big advantages to LEDs beyond the fact that they can produce millions of different colors. First, LEDs produce very little heat when compared to the incandescent light, where heat is produced in the filament to the point that the light is created. Second, LEDs are therefore much more efficient because they do not waste as much energy in the form of heat. Lastly, LEDs can produce extremely bright light that can be seen from very far away. Did you enjoy this video learning about LEDs? Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to Illustrate to Educate to support more simple and objective videos on topics that matter. Also, be sure to click on the links in the description to check out Lumary's revolutionary LED products.